takes me back to something that I like to take you.
Man, I'm tired of shit, man.
I remember when it was just a dream, but it came a reality with so many material things. The love we once shared is no longer there. We're both running fast, and going nowhere. But now it looks like it's all at an end. I'd like to pick up the pieces and start all over again. But I've got to do it my way. That's the only way I know. Lord help me. I'm tired of going on the insane, and I refuse to let anything stand in my way. Standing my way.
Watch it change.
Yeah. I remember when I was 17.
When I be listening to Bobby Womack, my girl be like, she'll come and peep in the room like, she already know my style though. You know what I mean? But what I really want to speak about today is a Virginia 18-year-old is charged with attempted capital murder after hitting a deputy with her car. An 18-year-old in Stafford County was arrested for allegedly hitting a Stafford County Sheriff's Office deputy with her vehicle during a traffic stop. And she looks like a little kid, right? On Tuesday, November 29th, just before 3:45 p.m., a deputy noticed the driver of a Nissan Altima was driving recklessly approaching the Garrisonville Road and Eustis Road area. The deputy attempted a traffic stop by parking his sheriff's office motorcycle in front of the Nissan. When he approached the Nissan, the driver, Kimura, hit the deputy with her car and crashed into the motorcycle. The deputy was knocked into another lane of travel as she drove eastbound into a Dodge Ram that was stopping traffic. She then backed up and pulled forward over the median into the westbound lanes. Once she cleared the intersection, she returned to the eastbound lanes until she reached the area. She and a juvenile passenger abandoned the crash car near the car wash and fled into the woods. The deputy was transported to the hospital and treated for his injuries. Police attempted to establish a perimeter around the scene. They located and detained the juvenile passenger, but she was able to escape the perimeter. Warrants were obtained for her for attempted capital murder, 2 counts of felony hit and run, felony eluding, reckless driving, and no valid driver's license. This is an ongoing case and additional charges are possible. Now, I got a third job at a homeless shelter, right? And, you know, I don't really do anything. I just be in there asleep. But it was crazy, right? This dude came up to me, right? He was like, yo, you volunteer here? And I said, kinda. And he said, y'all get paid? And the biggest problems that we have, for example, is, say, for example, this bed right here is like a cot. You know, we've got 60 cots inside of a basketball gym. And this one particular gentleman, he likes to picture him laying down across the bed, right? And he'll have his butt cheeks out. So he's laying down, he's laying across like this, and his butt and his pants are down. He's like sagging. like he's sagging like this, both cheeks out. And one of the gentlemen came to me and said, look, man, the guy in the cot next to me, his ass is out. And he has a tattoo on his ass of somebody's face. So I come out and I wake up, go into the gymnasium, see the guy. He has a big tattoo on his ass. And he's asleep. You know, all I see is him like this. And his ass is just like exposed. And he's like, man, this guy keeps farting and stuff. And it's just like, you know, stuff like that I got to deal with. But it's so crazy, man. So the guy's laying across like this, just farting as he sleeps. And the farts are landing at the guy who's in the cot next to him. And you know, the only conclusions that I can give you about my analysis of the homeless, the displaced people, is they're good people. They're just, you know, it's a lot of guys who have jobs who are homeless. And there are some people who feel, why is it that the homeless shelter can't just be for guys who work? Why is it that the guys who don't work, you know, because it first come, first serve, you got to come at 5 in the evening. It's only 60 beds. The guys who work, if they get extra hours at work, they can't make it by 5. So the guys who hang out in the streets all day, they're going to come at 2 o'clock, stand in line, get their spot, and they're going to get a bed. Well, meanwhile, the guys who work, they're going to be out in the cold. So there's an attitude out there that says, we need to focus on the guys who are homeless and work. But it is what it is, you know. It is what it is, man. You know, that's what happens. You help, you try to help, and then you encounter problems, and then you have different solutions. You have different perspectives on the solutions. And like I said, man, I'm just there picking up game. You know, I respect the gentlemen. I treat them like men, and it is what it is, you know. Peace.